Now we see walking through a directory. Consider this folder C, which is contain delicious folder and subfolder cat, and subfolder cats contain these two files like that. Subfolder walnut contain waffles, subfolder that contain butter.txt. This is a walk of full folder C in that delicious. Okay, in the same way, if you want to display or to read the content of a folder, you have to write a small code in the Python. Go through this code. See, import os to import os model, and there is a method called as os.walk, os.walk. And now I am going to traverse through D drive. Okay, therefore I given D colon two backslashes, and in that I have to traverse through folder name, subfolders, and file names. These are all reserved keywords in the os.walk method, and it is displaying folder name. First, it displays the folders which are available in the D drive one by one. Okay, and inside the for loop there is a subfolder in the subfolders, for subfolder in the subfolders. In a particular subfolder there will be subfolders, okay, or in a particular folder there will be subfolders. It displaying all subfolder names, as well as it displaying all the files which are available in the particular subfolder. If you execute this, you can see in the D drive there are many files as well as folders. Here it's going to traverse through file as well as folder. These are all folders. Okay, folders. These are all folders, as well as it is traversing through files. And next, through each folder it traverses to see the content of or to read the content of subfolder. Okay, each folder it is traverses through to see the contents. Okay, all folders contains, see, recycle bin contains this many files. Many files, whatever files recycle, it's available in recycle. Lot of files are there, lot of related files are there in the recycle. Like that, it traverses through all the folders, files as well as subfolders. Okay, there are lot of files and subfolders available in D drive. Now, if you want to walk through some other folder, consider as an example D Arduino folder. D Arduino folder you are giving to walk through. Okay, when you execute this, you can see in D Arduino there is C training folder, as well as there are many files in the D Arduino folder, and in the C training file there are two files. Okay, it's displaying this both the file. Like that, it traverses through all the subfolders of Arduino folder. You can see that in the D drive, in the Arduino folder, there are four files and one subfolder which contains two subfiles. Okay, this is about traversing through directory by using os.walk method. Now we work with the zip files. To work with zip files, we need to import zip file model, okay, and os model to change the directory. Now I have changed the directory to D drive. Okay, in the D drive there is a file named news.zip. I want reference of that zip file. to get reference of that zip file, you have to use zip file models, zip file method. See the difference between this z and this z. Here this z is small, here it is capital. Here this f is small, here it is capital. You are getting reference of new.zip and storing into example zip variable. Okay, from example zip reference, you are getting the name list that displays whatever files available in the new.zip. Now, from name list, if you want to get information of abc.txt file, okay, from name list you are getting information of abc.txt file. That information you are storing in the variable spam info. And if you want to display the original file size, you have to get file size keyword. Okay, from spam info, get the file size. It prints the file size as 64 byte. This is original file size. And next, compressed size. Compressed file size is accessible through compressed size keyword from spam info variable. Okay, compressed file size is 60 bytes. Now, how much it is smaller? Compressed file is smaller. How much? It is nothing but percentage of original file size divided by compressed file size, and after division, rounding the result by two decimal places and then taking the percentage. Okay, now it gives 64/60 1.0x. okay, percentage sx 1.0x smaller. It is normally showing the same size, but when you try to compile big compress, when you try to compress big files, then you can see the difference. If you want to extract the zip file contents, you have to give extract all method, okay, which is from a particular zip file. For example, new.zip is a zip file I want to extract. Its reference is stored in the example zip. Now example zip.extract all extracts all the files of new.zip to current folder. Current folder is a D drive. Okay, now if you run, it extracts and stores extracted folder in the current folder D drive. Okay, if you see, if you go through the D folder, just open D folder, you can get, you refresh D drive. Okay, okay, refresh D drive, and in the D drive the new zip file will be extracted. If you want to extract particular file from the new.zip folder, then you have to give example zip. This is a reference to zip file. Example zip.extract, that file name. Now it is extracted to current folder. Current folder is D drive. Okay, if you want to extract to the given destination, then you can give file name and then destination folder as a new folder name. Okay, I have given the folder name as new, which is available in the D drive. To this folder, it extracts abc.txt file. Okay, after execution of this, if you open the D drive, you can see here new folder. Okay, new folder is created. Okay, new folder is created, and you can see the extracted file of new zip folder, that is abc.txt, here in the created new folder. Indicates abc.txt file is extracted to new folder, okay, as I given in the code. Now we see how to create a zip file. and adding file to zip file. To create a zip file, we have to give command zip file method. In that, file name has to be created in WMOD. Okay, from zip file model, zip file method, name of the file, comma W as the writing mode. And the reference is stored in the variable new zip. And if you want to write a file to the created zip file, then which file you want to write, give the file name and then indicate the mode of compressing. Mode of compressing or type of compressing is given as here, zip file dot zip deflated. It is nothing but algorithm going to used by the write method to write spam.txt or to compress spam.txt to zip file. Okay, try to execute the same code in the Jupyter. Okay, now we are in currently new folder. I have given os dot change directory to new folder. In the new folder, we are going to create pqr.zip file in a W mode, that is write mode. Okay, and reference is stored in the new zip variable. Now, by using this reference variable, you are going to use write method to compress abc.txt, to compress abc.txt in the zip file. See, this abc.txt should be available in new folder. That available file, existing file, will be compressed in pqr.zip by using algorithm deflated. If you try to run this code, okay, if you try to run this code, you can see the output in the new folder where pqr.zip is created. Go to the folder dnew. Okay, see, this is dnew folder where pqr.zip is created. Inside pqr.zip, abc.txt file is zipped. Okay, abc.txt file is zipped. And this is execution of the writing the zip file into, writing the file that is required into the zip file. So abc is available file in the new folder. It is stored in the zip file after zipping or after compressing.